John, secret of John, who became a mighty apostle of God. What the secret is, he was a burning person. He offered himself to be burnt. Second, while he was burnt, he allowed himself, he was carrying the light of God and he was shining. So his purpose is, he saw himself as a burning, not only burning person, but also a person who is carrying the light of God. Can you see yourself? The world is lying in darkness. People are covered with the darkness. People are discouraged, disappointed, worried, and trying to blame each other, hurt each other. In this moment, we come with the light of God and say, even if you are a worst sinner, there is a Savior for you. Return to Him. Even if you are a sick, come to Jesus. He will heal you. He will forgive you. You are the one who can give light, the hope, the courage, to build up people, to raise up people. So John was, on the one hand, he was a burning person. He was burning himself. He offered himself. He has no desire. No, it's fire. I will not come. It will take away all my energy. It will take away all my time. It will take away my shape. Once it is on the fire, it has lost itself. No, I can't do this. Only this much I will come. I will fire you burn. I will come till here. No. He was a burning. He was a burning person. He offered himself to the fire. Second, he was shining. He was shining. The light he received, he took wherever he went. He said, this is the truth. This is the truth. Return. And you will live. Otherwise, you are going to die. The enemy is not going to, he is not interested to make you, to give you fun and laughter. He will come through fun and laughter. His goal is to make you zero. He wants you to be, put you down in front of everybody. He wants to humiliate you. He wants to make you an evil person. He wants to be part of him. He wants your soul. He is not simply interested in just making you to sleep, during the prayer time. He makes you to sleep. No, he doesn't want you to listen to the word of God. He wants you to be bothered about yourself and tie up with your darkness. And then he can use you as he wishes. But John the Baptist, he was a burning. He offered himself completely. And having received the Lord, he was busy in giving the Lord. He was giving in the light. Read, continue. John 5:35. John was a burning, a shining, yes.
And you were willing to rejoice for a while in his life.
So for a while. For a while means for a particular time, certain time, certain hours, certain days, we were rejoicing with him. Yes. When they heard the word of God, by hearing the word, your faith grows. By hearing the word, your courage comes in. But people did not know, John himself did not know. It is only for a while. For a while, we were rejoicing in the light he was bringing to the world. And suddenly, he was caught. He was thrown. That is the end. So, while you are in the light, get into the light. Possess the light. Shine in the light. And show that light to the world for which you and I are called. You are the light of the world, Jesus said. No one hides the light under the bed. I have given you the light. Jeremiah 1:4-5. Even before you were in the womb of your mother, I have chosen you and separated you. There are so many who are born with you. They are not in your mission. There are many, maybe your husband, your wife, your children, your parents, they are in a different world. But I have separated you. Even when you are in office, you hear my call. When things are going wrong, you hear my voice. You are mine. You are mine. Many times you said, I will not be. It's enough for me, but it's not possible for you. Your God will pull you again and again. You are mine. That's why he says in Isaiah 43 verse 21, I have separated you that my glory may shine in you and you may carry my glory to this sinful, sick world. This world is looking for people and you are the dream. You are the vision of mine. You are my desire. You are my plan. And remember, while when there is light, you grow in the light. And I warn you, the Lord says, the darkness is coming. The day of gloom comes when nobody can shine. You will be crying for it, but nobody will be giving you. Yes. Continue. Burn. He was a burning, shining lamp, and he was shining for a while. Yes.
But I have a greater evidence than that of John.
Continue that previous sentence.
I have a testimony greater than John.
So he became a testimony. He became for so many to refer. Oh, that man, John. Oh, he spoke to me that. I touched me. Oh, that man led me to God. Oh, that man spoke something that has affected me. Oh, that man sang the song that led me to God. John became a testimony in his own way. He was a burning, he was a shining, he was a testimony. Because he knew this only for a while. He can't be testimony all the time. He was shouting like a warrior. Oh, brood of snakes. He could tell the king, Herod, you have taken your brother's wife wrong. He brought him, put there. He can only shout at the jail where nobody can listen. Suddenly the enemy is going to come and attack him with the depression. You are such an apostle. Now, did God leave you? Did God forsake you? The more you work for God, the enemy will be coming behind you. And being in India, you have 330 crores of forces coming behind you. It's not easy. If you don't hold on to the light, next minute is the darkness. It is not that we are fighting with the main problem with us is the main thing God asks us is not that we get frightened of darkness. No, we have to hold on to the light. We are called to hold on to the light. The plan, the call of God is, my son, my daughter, hold on to my light. If you don't hold on to my light, darkness will come.